again. I feel like, I mean, he was doing well against Yoshi, against the zoning aspect of Yoshi quite well with Incineroar. That being said, Ness kind of eats Incineroar for breakfast, and Zero to None plays pretty different from most Zeldas I see, where he doesn't really take... He'll initiate his zoning tool, but then he'll run in, and he'll either catch you shielding or...
Instead of like waiting, instead of like really, really methodically, like sort of waiting to see how you react to a lot of his projectile conditioning, he
just runs in.
Yeah, he just runs in.
He's like, I got my homie next to me sprinting. I got Usain Bolt, Phantom Knight right next to me. I'm running
in. What are you going
to
do? In a double situation, you're going to pick the golden thread.
Yeah.
Like the perfect escape option out of my Phantom into Foiling.
It's not
going
to happen.
Like, no, you don't have that kind of awareness right now. But Zankai actually opting for the Mewtwo, which I believe is a much better choice. Right now, Zero to None is already like doing a great job of just keeping Zankai off of him using the neutral bees.
And I don't know what is going on offstage right now. Wow, almost, Zero to None almost dying right there. That was a perfect little spacing right there to get the good drift off of that. Zenkai accidentally, Stock Taker taking a very early stock loss there. I'm assuming he just lost his jump because offstage, Zelda and Ness can kind of have a field day on a...
Some of the most potent edge guarders in the whole entire game. But right away, both of them holding on to all 3-2 stocks to 2-1. This is a really, really big lead for PK Chris and Zero to None right now.
Oh,
and
my
PK
God.
PK Chris is able to land a PK Thunder to not enough to kill Zankai yet because I think he was at 0%. Zankai is trying to reflect the Phantoms I see using his confusion, but
doing?
Unable to land it. I really, really like that down air from Chris because he was trying to lead a higher recovery.
Dude. And stock loss all three stocks in a minute.
And reading the drop down.
He's dead. He's dead. What the hell was that game one? Dara, what was that? Literally, what just happened? They got caught off stage. Why did they pick to Smashville for game one is what I want to know.
Why would you pick?
You played into one of Zelda and Ness's best stages immediately when you had a wolf on your team.
So
why did they do that?
A character like Zelda is just able to like control the entire stage with just one projectile. On a stage like Smashville, Phantom is just able to cover the entirety of the platform while still covering the ledge.
Yeah.
And Ness just has like a field day with the yo-yo on both of these characters. So they need a mix-up on the stage and they just need like a quick like breather. They need to like really, really like break down what just happened to them.
I feel like, so what, the main discrepancy there was that Stock kept getting caught off stage and Chris and Zero to None were able to cover all of off stage without mucking over each other, and that could be really hard for Wolf to deal with. Wolf has one of two mix-ups, which is going to be side B or up B, and if you get hit by at least even one, just one Ness aerial off stage as Wolf, your stock is pretty much cooked. Zenkai really couldn't get in fast.
That is going to be a shield break, trying to get the F smash, but Stock Taker doing a fantastic job of being there for Zenkai, making sure he doesn't get it. But I feel like Villager is a phenomenal choice from Stock Taker rather than the Wolf, because Villager is a character that does really, really well against both Ness and Zelda, I want to say. But PK Chris should know that... Zenkai and his K. Rool, they have a hitbox on the way going up. Yo-Yo won't really work that easily. PK Chris trying to do something a little bit saucy, but unfortunately his angle was not optimal to get the PK Thunder 2, instead actually just bouncing on the stage.
I think what we're going to see for this game, at least as far as the yellow team's game plan, is team up on Zenkai. I mean, when you have a heavy against Zelda, and that was a perfect recovery right there. Stock getting a little too overzealous right there with that Sebi, not knowing, or not remembering, rather, that Zelda can hold down over the ledge when she's teleporting to play a pretty big hitbox right after it. And Zero to None has no fear offstage. The ledge is also this man's playground. Excellent tech right there.
Right now, they have to find a way to take out Zenkai stock, but same applies to Zero to None. Zero to None sitting at 155%. Did he just PK Thunder 2 across the stage?
He literally did it. No discernible reason whatsoever. It's just that I think the intimidation also from Chris is working. I noticed that Stock and Zenkai are committing to a lot of defensive options and respecting the Thunder a little bit too much. It actually ended up eating the stock because Zenkai thought he was safe because... PK Thunder 2 does slow down once you go through a solid object. So after going through a Stock Taker, the momentum got slowed down. Oh my
God!
What the fuck?
That was an amazing conversion. That was so good.
It's over.
The fact that PK Chris was just ready for something like that was absolutely nuts. And they're just so up on Stock Taker right now.
Bro.
And that is grand finals.
That was a massacre.
That's it.
That was a massacre.
I have never seen that level
Mark,
of play.
That was